Hallelujah. As the old Kiddushim would say, that's all right. That's all right. That's all right. Yisrael, that's all right. No, I gotta see them the kingdom. That's all right. All the trials may come. And they go, oh, tribulation may come upon Israel. I got him on, but I will trust in Yahweh, because I know that he has made it right. I'm all right with my trials. Oh, I'm all right when I suffer for Yeshua. Oh, I know that it's all right with Yah. Come on, Israel. Yah is all right with Yah. It's all right in my mind. No, it's all right deep down in me. I trust in Yah. Day and night, I call upon the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. Oh, I know it's all right. It's all right. Come on, Israel. It's all right to cry sometimes. It's all right. I know it's all right. It's all right to suffer for Yah sometimes. I cry to Yah. He hears my cry, oh, call on the name of my Abba. He brings me comfort and security, oh, in the name of Yahshua. Oh, it's all right, it's all right, oh, it's all right, it's all right, I know it's all right. Nobody can tell me it's not all right with ya. Oh, I know it's all right. Oh, it's all right. Deep in my life, Yah has given me the assurance. Come on! The assurance of the name of Yahshua. You can't tell me it's not all right. I tell you that is all. It's all right. Ah, it's all right. It's all right. Come on, Israel, and sing. It's all right. Oh, sing to Yah. It's all. Oh, it's all right. Oh, I know it's all right. It's all right, oh, it's all right, oh, it's all right, little ones, it's all right, I know it's right, oh, I know it's all right, it's all right, you can't tell me it's not, I know it's all right. Oh, I suffer the pain in my mind, and sometimes I ask Yah, why, oh, me, oh, Yah will say it's all right. Don't worry about a thing. It's all right, oh, it's all right. Oh, it's all right, little children. Oh, the pains come and they go. Oh, you cry at night and you wonder why. It's all right, oh. Oh, it's all right. It's all right. Oh, I'm telling you. It's all right. Oh, all right. Oh. Hallelujah. Oh. Yes, it is. Oh, it's all right. Don't worry about a thing. It's right. Oh, it's all right. Oh, I know it's all right. It's all right. Oh, I know it's all right. That's right. Oh, yeah. It's all right, it's all right. Oh, it's all right. It's all right with me. Oh, I know it's all right. That's all right. Hallelujah. 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 Praise Him. Ah, yes. You may be seated. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I say to all Israel, Yahshua's mighty name, Shabbat Shalom, we greet you all for this great Shabbaton that Yah has granted unto Israel. I look for the delight of the Shabbat. We may have Shaphat. We rest in the comfort of His Torah. We must understand that no one can understand the Shabbaton unless Yah puts Nathan bestow unto that one the beauty of His Yanach. Is that He placed us in the place of quietness, that we can be resolute in our rest, that we take great comfort in the rest of Almighty Yah. And in that Yanach, we obtain rest. We literally obtain rest, so He puts us in His Shabbat. That we may enjoy the Shabbaton, a time of rest, that we literally can be quiet, we can settle down, because the only way that we can understand the Yanach of Yah, He must put, as He did with Adam, He put him in the garden. And there was quiet, Shalom, His Yanach, the power of His personality and Him, rested upon the bosom of Adam. And from the time of Adam to now, where He sinned, we have struggled with one of the most viable commands, Zachach HaShabbat. Remember the Shabbat. He tells us to shamach, to guard it as you would guard precious gems. And keep it. Shemach chadosh. Keep it set apart. That doesn't mean your damn ball games, playing with your sons and daughters. It means for us to enjoy the Yanach, the time of quietness and shalom. I'm glad that Yah has granted me simple. I like that word, shaddak. That's what a simple-minded person is. It is shaddak. It means that their minds are open for the instructions of Yah. We find a damn stupid generation. This is one of the most damnable, stupid generations since time began. When Yah looked for man, hell, he couldn't find one. And everybody thinks that he's a man. The word ish denotes the physicality of one above all. He has a strength of maturity. That hell, you don't have to, or he doesn't have to come to you. You'll run to him. That's a fact. I'm an observer of people, the expression of their faces, and how they watch and look and what I can perceive in my thoughts, their perception. I was out yesterday, and there was this young, she was what we identify is as Hispanic. But that is a form of a ethnic or a divide of racial term to segregate a people. And so as I'm walking in the store, my head was uncombed. It was, as we would say, nappy. My beard was disheveled. And so as I'm walking, when I walk with an astute manner. I do. I don't walk like a boy. So I watched this young lady. It was not a lust. It wasn't that. I watched her as she watched me. And her eyes, I'm looking at this young lady's eyes. As not as though that she was lusting for a damn old man. But I could see in her eyes she sensed the sensitivity of gravity with age. She saw beauty that was beyond the beauty of what men call beautiful. I'm telling you. She saw one that, she saw this fatherly mind that brings about maturity in a daughter. And I'm telling you, she did not take her eyes off me. She just watched as she came toward me. I'm toward her, coming toward her. This is the strength of the Zachin. Not one that runs his damn mouth. I don't want to go that way, but I shall. And so when the young woman saw that, I could sense. Most old men, when they see some young woman look at them, they think that they're lusting for them. It's not the truth. You can't do much anyway. Silly old man. Stupid old fool. Jackass. Self-grandizing, pompous beast of a bastard. I don't look at it that way. I give them something to ponder. I command their attention. That's a fact. And that's the strength of an ish. I believe what's in the book. You may not. But I do. I greet you all in Yahshua HaMashiach's mighty name. You that have joined us on the live stream, the live video or audio, we are having some difficulties here, and the preciseness of our visual perception would and can be somewhat blurred. And we're missing a little piece that only costs $12. That has been the diagnostics as of this hour. So we have expedited that little piece that we will have it on the Yom Sheni Monday, that we can expedite this process. Because we want to come to you, our friends, with great clarity, not only in speech, but in the visual and the audio, because it is vital for us in this time. We need strong koach men, not these little damn effeminate boys. They're so easily offended. They get upset about every damn thing and they don't know a damn thing. They're boys. The other day, Sipura, she pulled my hood on my head. And so Seria, she looks at me and she says, "Papi, you look old." I said, "Toda." I said, "You're a little girl and you're young. I'm becoming an old man. And I get older every day. I don't want to be a young man. I do not have the virile nature and the strength of my young ak. But have the virileness of wisdom and understanding of Torah that supersedes the excellence of their strength. Yah takes no ga'on in the strength of the horse. Nothing like a thoroughbred. Nor does he even consider the beauty and the strength of the massive legs of a man. There's nothing more beautiful than the strength of a man's legs. I'm not talking about the steroids and deuce. I'm talking about legs of strength that have labored. Legs of strength that have been built upon masculine work. Nothing more beautiful. Well, I know that the world takes the beauty of a man's leg and say that the woman's leg, they say long legs. Yah doesn't speak of her legs, but it speaks of the strength of a man's leg. His kingdom strength, his power to speak with great authority. We need that. I don't elaborate with men much because it's so difficult to find men. Laranacha, boys. And the word that is used for man, or the word nacha, that means youthful, young, immature boys. The synonym of that is the same thing to express the beauty and the strength of a man. How do you know that? Well, I take time to teach myself. I can hear you elaborate and exacerbate a verse, but I will never get the understanding until I lahach and then hear you speak on that to bring emunah, faith, to my bosom. We don't have that today. And I don't apologize to no weak man. Anytime you fight a man that's weak, he's always relishing his emotions. Well, I don't like that. Damn your likes of your dislikes, boy. See, a strong man knows that everything works for his tongue if he loves Yah. But a damn boy, you will see the expression in his anger, his juvenile, pompous, damn attitude. Damn all boys. I love the bane of Yisra'iah, his children. That's why I make things clear. I like you, man. Not too many people I like. I want some fish for tabernacle. You got months. And I want that. Got plenty for the gardener? We will have plenty. I want you to catch fish, man. That's all right. That's all right. That's all right. Hallelujah. You love me back there, Imma Daphne. You love me? I know you do. You knew me before I knew me. I know that's right. No doubt about that. We greet our friends, our precious Ach, William, your whole Tiffany there in Kentucky, with all of that large skuburo you all have. We greet you in Yeshua's name. And the congregation, come on, say to them, Shabbat,
Shabbat.
Shalom.
Shalom.
We all greet you all. He has had great difficulties. And what I don't hear from them frequently, almost after every Shabbat, I know that their difficulties. And they wrote this morning to let me know that there were some difficulties. So we greet you, our precious Achi, your Chutz, and the family, in Yeshua's name, may the healing. He is Yarafa, he is the healer of Yisra'iah. And also our precious Ach and friend Micaiah, his Isha, his son Sophonia, and our precious Ahot Ross that's there with them today as they gather. We greet you all in Yeshua's mighty name, our precious Ach Yaakov there in McKinney, Texas, our precious friend Mariana in Indiana, our David Straw there in Indiana as well, our Zachain David there in Baltimore, precious young man. He tells me all the time, my father would have loved you, and to hear you speak, he would have embellished every word, because his father was preaching this in the 40s and 50s. He knew the truth of Yah. He said he would have loved you. He would have loved you, Reach. And he always tell me there are not many strong men, period. In the physicality of a man, and certainly in the spiritual dynamics of a man, there are not many. So when you find one, he's a jewel. He's a precious jewel. We need that. I will show us why as I proceed. We need that. We greet you, our precious Ak. He has been a compatriot of faithfulness, our Ak, Charles Davis. Those that are gathering with him out there in Los Angeles, California, we're coming to tear the wicked house down. We greet you, our precious friend, Zachin Thomas, there in Memphis, Tennessee, that is so faithful, and his vital assistance is beyond expressive superlatives for me to speak. He has been a faithful warrior. He put us on the radio station in Memphis for nearly a year. And did not charge us one dime. He could have sold that time to Christian broadcasts. He didn't want them on. And he will play the messages from this congregation for hours, sometimes 6 hours a day, to bring not only warning, but condemnation on a wicked city as Memphis. A plethora of whorehouses that's beyond the spectrum or speck. so numerated that one cannot even equate them with numbers. Yet he has been precious and kind, and precious Jacob there in Jacksonville, Florida. We brought you our Tesner and all of those that gather with you there in Florida as well. They have been so kind, so supportive. You're not going to find many supporting me. You understand? It is one thing about a cowardly dog. He is always ready to run. That's why Akshimri said, they said, I'm leaving. Go, dogs. I don't want to be around dogs anyway. Damn dogs. I like dogs. I do. I don't love dogs. I like them. I care for it. But I don't want a coward dog. And I don't like a dog that bites. A bark. I had a dog. He was a Rottweiler. He was a monster as of a beast. One day the little children was planning his food. I said, oh, you doing that to them? You did it to me. I said, eat your food, boy. And I went and got my steel cable because he was every bit 135 pounds. He was a monster. I said, come here, boy. Oh, he was happy. His belly was full. And so I put the lock on his neck that regardless of how he was squirming and trying to get loose, he wasn't going to get loose. And I tied him to a tree. Yeah, you can get the Humane Society. I speak to the dogs of Israel. You call them dogs. And I took me a rod about that big, and I commenced to beat on that piece, that the veins swollen in his neck, his cheek teeth were warning me. I said, no, sir, you're not going to do this, dog. And I beat him, and I beat him. When I finished, I left him there for a week, and I didn't feed him either. I woke up on him. He knew who was the Alpha. He knew. Next time the children played in his food, there was not even a twitch of a bark. And so when the dog barked, they're barking loud. They're not saying anything. They have nothing of expression that cause maturity to develop in one that we come to the fullness of knowledge of age, Yeshua HaMashiach. As our friend, as he operated in the very Ruach of Amori, he says to us, it's time to move beyond the elementary things of Yah. That's all people talk about today, the elementary things. There's no depths of Torah. We haven't dug into the depths of the mind of Yeshua HaMashiach. We shall do that today. I want the greatest gift Yah offers. You want that? Who wants it? I do. Although I may prophesy, speak in tongues, speak from wisdom, but I show you a gift more excellent than all of that. These men today are fools, women too. I show you one that is much greater than all your prophecy, all your wisdom of Torah, all your excellence of your broken linguistic of talk. I show you one more excellent. Well, what is it, man? It is the Ahab, the Ahava. Simply the love of Yah. Yeah. When a man possess that, when a woman possess, I will. Come on, man. You cannot correct a damn fool because the first thing of a fool, he gets angry. That's what Torah says. I like you, old woman. These two have been with me and this Eman for a long time. What are the first sitters? The first day our doors were open, that old woman. And all these years she was young. She had the Yafef of Yah, that even there were juvenile boys that were young and strong would have been impressed, and they were. I know what I'm saying. Yah has kept her. He's going to keep you till you die as long as you shut your mouth and listen. Hallelujah. Isn't that something? Three women. Where are the men that told me they love me? Where are these coward boys? That's what little boys do, little children. I ain't gonna play because you did that. I don't give a damn who walks away from me. I've seen the best of them turn their hearts away from me. It doesn't mean a damn thing to me. It doesn't trouble me. It doesn't bother me. Not at all. Go. Leave. Hallelujah. I want strong men. We need that in this hour. You can't fight the battle with deserters and weak men. They desert. The smallest of complications of confirmation of them, they desert you. I will take you few and we will do more than an army of men. I want to continue off where I left off last week as our friend continued to tell us that he will, and we must, stir up our pure minds. Not just any kind of a damn mind. There's only one mind that is pure. That's the mind of Yahshua HaMashiach. And he commanded us on Hithve Imats, I'm stirring, that we stir up our pure minds by derech, by the halach, the way, the direction of zacha, of remembering what he spoke to us. We must remember. Retain it. That it become a zikron, a memoria of great value, of great substance. That's what it is. He gave his Shabbat to as an oath, a sign between his nation Yisrael and him. So it ought to be a memoria, a zikron, in our minds, something that we celebrate, that we think of it every day, that we ponder it, it's on our minds, and we always make the necessary preparation. It's not just stop working. It's not stopping your mitzvah. That's what the word work implies, mitzvah. But it's causing our minds, our thoughts, that are against Yah to be suppressed in the way that we examine and judge everything about us. Why? That we bring no damn filthy, wicked offering into the house of Yah. Your hands are filthy. They're full of sin and blood. Not only are they filthy with sin, they're filthy because you don't wash them. I'm a warrior. I love to fight. Where's Abner? I said, which jab is the easiest one to detect? I said, that one. I said, but this one, you can't see that one. Always a jab straight. That is the most undetectable jab it is. You can detect that, but that one, you can't detect it. You can't detect it. That's how most folks get knocked out. You can't detect that. So when a man is straight, you can detect that. And I'm straight. I am Yeshua. Straight, not from the hip, but from the book. I said, get your defense right, boy. You don't even know how to hold your wrist. Hit me, you're going to break it. Hallelujah. Now the little boys began to get upset. You began to become emotional. You began to become bitter with me. You still can't whip me. How about that? He's a little boy, he can't whip me. Hey, Papi. You boast? No, no, no. I make my boast in Yeshua HaMashiach. Because I have that mind. We're at a time that the Torah talks about the Acharith. The Acharith. Just like the beginning is the Bereshit, we talk about the Acharith. It is not only the end and the combination of all of the tyranny against Yabrot under one umbrella to be judged. It is the last seconds of the last of the Acharith of the time. You will know that when the mind begins to purport itself above the excellence of Yah's truth, when one began to grandize themselves in their damn filthy righteousness. The righteousness is as a filthy rag. It is as the nidah, a minister rag, from a woman that has bled for 30 days and has not changed the rag. And so they're full of nidah, they're filthy and they're unclean. So we're not just in the last days. We're in the last of the beginning of Yah's judgment. He did not always destroy Israel when he judged her. He would bring his nation out of all of the judgments. But this whole offering, this Sheach, the burnt offering, is going to be whole. What does that imply? Well, the whole body of Israel is going to be whole. It's going to be one. It's going to be complete in HaMashiach. That's what it's going to be. It's going to be complete in Yeshua HaMashiach. A time of preparation. A time we know that we are being thrust into this time when there's a spirit that rises up. When this mindset rises against Yah, the holocaust of the Ish, the destruction of Almighty Yahweh. And I ask you the question, who shall survive? Or who shall be cool? In the 60s, that was a vernacular of our speech, cool, K-O-O-L. Who's going to survive? Who shall be sustained? Who shall maintain? And above all, who shall contain Yah's Emet in the midst of their bosom through the fiery, the Nuah? Zakin has been trying to bring that out to us. The Nuah, the fiery trials of Yah. And that word expressed one thing. It means to shine forth. What shall sustain us? What will maintain us? What will be the maintenance of our minds that we shall shine in the excellence of the light of Yeshua HaMashiach? Shaul said, I would love to feed you all with lashem bread. That is beyond your ability. He said, but you're still little boys. I got to feed you milk. That's what he said. We're not a generation that is prepared. We're in the Acharith, the Holocaust, of true Yisrael. When they are whole, that's the only way we're going to overcome. I want to inject again one of the verses I read last week as I proceed in this matter. Hallelujah. I want to inject from Yeshaya, Isaiah chapter 14. Yeshaya. Chapter 14. As I spoke to us on Shabbat, this is a mind, and the constitution of this mind, not only is it diabolical, opposed to Yah, but it is a mind that esteems the worth of one's damn flesh as though that it has great properties of value. Doesn't possess a damn thing. All flesh is as grass. It stinks. It inhabit, or it is inhabited by lies and corruption. That's why we must impel the lust and the affection of this damn stuff we call bazaar. In those days, they would say, he's nothing but a buzzard. They were speaking that Hebrew talk. They didn't know it. Bazaar. Bazaar. They would say he was a buzzard. You ever heard that one? You never heard that one? Oh, old woman, you must have been locked down and cloaked down in the house. You ever heard that, Laima? Get out of here. I'm the only one. You ever heard it? I know. He's a timer. That's what they were saying. He's ain't nothing but old buzzer. Look at him. See, this young boy can remember things. I remember them. That's how they talk. See that? See the confirmation? Where were you all? I will, man. A mind that is diabolically opposed to Yah. It is a mind that is, its tenets are built by Nahash. That is what the serpent said, the Tani. The day you defy Yah, the day that you renounce him, you will become, quote, a god, unquote. Yada, experience it in your own environment. What is ra and what is tav? What is the most excellent thing of your life? You don't have to answer me, Zachinia Rameya, put you on the spot. Can I tell you the most excellent thing about each individual's life, my life, your life? You don't have to buy it. Can I tell you that supersedes every concept of reality, what is tzaddik, righteous according to Torah? Can I tell you? It is your own damn filthy ways. All goal, all haderech, all the ways of a man. They are Yoshua, they're straight, they're upright in his own damn ayin. His own damn eyes. So that's what's straight. You don't want anyone to deal with your damn crooked paths. Your mind is twisted, it's immature, it's crooked. When you tell a wise man anything, he loves you. He says, man, I love you. Reprove a wise man, he will love you. Rebuke a damn foolish woman, you will get yourself a blood. A blood. He's not right. Go to hell. You child of hell. His truth is right. All of your ways are right. Everything you do is right. There's only one way. And in that way, it is light. And it is refined the more by Torah. How about the hearing of the Torah? By the hearing. You must develop your hearing. Your hearing. Zachin Bermi, in his days, he would always express that. Shemach. Obeying with the passion of desire. To hear and to obey. That is what Shemach. That's why the broadcast, Yishemach Yisrael, with a passion. Men today don't have that. But I'm moving on. This is the mind that Torah calls. It is a mind that is called Gaun. 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 It is a mind that is hubris, full of pride. Immature men think that when they talk, and they don't even have a command of the grammatics of language. I know how to express things. I can bring things out in great dimension of detail because I'm a detailed man. And so they have this hubris, unsophisticated pride that they want majesty to be exalted above the simplicity of Torah. It's not difficult to understand. These mitzvah here, you tell me they're hard to understand? And upon those mitzvah hinge the writings of the chuchmah, the wisdom of Torah. Hallelujah. The statutes and all of the mandates that Yah commanded, they're based upon Him. Because these are His principles, because He is this. You wonder why young men don't grow? Because we got stupid-ass, silly old men and silly old women. I'm not taking nothing back. You don't have to love me. As a young boy, I didn't like clowning and playing around. There was an air of sophistication about me. Not that I thought I was someone. I did not participate in that kind of folly. I would stand back. I said, nah, that's not me there. And I would just walk away. No. When I was a young man, even in the military, our conversation wasn't about trying to exploit some woman. We talked about the things that were dynamic, political things. Malcolm X. We would listen to the last poets. We would sit in our, when we would sit together, 10, 12 of us. You had to be a commanding one of your sophistication of speech for everybody to shut up and listen to you. And I didn't back down to any of them because I was always prepared. I was always enlightening myself with certain things. I knew that was appropriate, whether it was political, the plight of the people of the diaspora, the dark-hued skin of people that they were suffering in this damn wicked nation. I always prepared myself. I was always up on the latest of things that would be of some substance of value to those that I would talk to. And I'm talking about young men that went on to become lawyers, teachers, detectives. These were not slouch of men. Hell, there were no outlets for them in the community. That's who I'm talking about. And we would call what we call, we would rap. Not what they call rapping, they will rap. You have to be sophisticated with it. I'm listening to you. You use that conjecture. You said that. Well, that's what you said, my friend. That was not the order. It was not manifest in that manner. This is what Malcolm said. He said this. So I wasn't going to let a boy from Cali outdo me. You boys from Mississippi, I like you. Or I like the fellow from Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina. I like them fellas. They were bright. They were smart. Louisiana. Like them southern boys. The northern cats, they didn't like me. They didn't. The New York City, the Baltimore, Maryland, the LA Cali, they didn't like me. Can I preach a little bit? He says here in Yeshaya 14:13, he identified with specifics, for you have, you have said, you have brought life to it from in your own life. You have said in your own life, he says, I will Allah, just like Allah, Allah Akbar. He said, I will Allah, I will ascend. I will excel with such great superiority to the Torah of Yah. That's why men are changing times. They're changing Torah. They're changing the emphasis on the things that are dynamic and strong. And they're relegating the people just to water and bread. We need the strong meat for this hour and this time. You can tell a strong man, if you go into the proximity of a gym or if you enter a gym, you will know who the strongest one is. He is much larger. He is much bolder. And everyone tends to skirt around him because they can't lift like him. And so it is with the strong man. He is identified. He is recognized. So it is with the strong woman. You can come in the gym and pretend you can. You can put 100-pound dumbbells in your hands and press them. You will deceive yourself and break your bones. So he says, this man says, I'm going to be superior. I'm going to excel the thresholds of the Torah. I will exalt me. I'm always talking about what I know. I'm always trying to show Yah what I know. And you don't know a damn thing. You will know that a man knows he Yah. The word know is Yada. When a man experiences the power of truth, you see it in his walk. You see it in his talk. You see it in him in his everyday activity. I will prove it. I will, man. The way he carry himself is not like every other man. He's different. The way he walk is not like every other man. The way he talks. He is what the Torah calls precious. Segula. Can I stop for a moment, my heart? If you go into the store, you see a garment. Let me take it to a different extreme. You see rings in the counter. And there is a piece of jewel that stands out above all, doesn't it? Sure it does. Because the diamonds are more beautiful with brilliant of light. They're cut. You're looking at a half carat. And all of a sudden you pierce upon this 8.5-carat ring. Everyone's attention is drawn to that ring. Although you cannot afford it, I'm giving you a scenario to show you the segula of a man, the gift of a man. Everyone is drawn to that, are they not? You don't have, the ring doesn't say anything, does it? But you are attached. I will, my friend. You are attached to that because of the excellence of his brilliancy. It doesn't shine like the half or the 2-carat rings, does it? It's light because of the precise cut of the diamonds are different than that because that's trash. But that diamond is cut by a master cutter. That is relegated to the Naha, the boys. But this man is a master. He's been cutting diamonds for 40 years. He just doesn't cut the diamond when he gets it. It may take him 2 or 3 years to study the diamond because every cut must be precise. How about that? And so all the other rings, they look somewhat dwarf. There is no light compared to that ring. So it is with the wise man. He doesn't have to say a damn thing. His light, people are drawn to him. So it is with the wise woman. This is the mind of Yisra'iyah. That's why the holocaust of the Ush, the fire of Yah, shall try a people. And how shall we survive, Yisra'iyah? How shall we, if I may use this expression, escape? How shall we survive? It's almost like you saw it coming, the raid coming. That's the word. Sarat. How do we escape? How to escape? You got your canned goods, it doesn't mean a damn thing. You have stored up your silver and gold, you put the burden on a poor woman. There in the Dominican Republic, she hears you. You put that burden upon that mother with no issue that is struggling, that loves Yah. She is striving to appease Yah, and you put that burden on her, you damn bastard, and tell her to buy gold and silver. I tell you, my precious Bathet Zionah, buy Ha'imet, buy the truth, and don't sell it. You buy the wisdom that this man speaks today. You buy the understanding this be know. You put that on her, you are a wicked bastard. You are a dog. You are a beast. And you tell me that's a gift of Yah? I show you a more excellent gift. That is above prophecy. That is above your wisdom to proclaim. It is the power of your love. Yeah. And these damn stupid men and women have no power of Ahab. Because you cannot love me until you love truth. And truth is one thing that are brought out unto us. That Yah makes himself known by one dimension of his power. That it is his mishpatim, his mishpat. He makes himself known by his judgment. And when you are judged, you despise judgment, you are damn fool. That's what this Holocaust is all about. It is about the judgment of Yah. You damn fool don't understand that when Yah receives it, his son or daughter, he corrects them be time. He corrects them with the rod of his correction. And you reject that, you are a damn hypocrite. I don't want to be around a damn hypocrite. I don't want to be around a damn false man. Get out of my damn face. He's cussing. No, I'm not having kala yet. I have a condemned you into hell. I'm a student. I'm a student, I'm not a boy. A student loves to study. A boy doesn't. And so when I hear a man like that proclaim, you said what you want to, it was excellent. Walked up to his father and said, God, he was a little sore then. I said, you put it in. He said, no, preacher. I said, no, shut your mouth. You put the foundation in him. I don't give a damn what he has done, I have done, he has done. He put, he no thought, what he put in him? He put in him the sense of a man. Get off your butt, boy. Get out of here. Like if you're done. Mama say, he. Don't say nothing. Ah, got a smile, huh? Talk to, all right now. Talk to me, man. I say, how can you build on something that has no sure foundation? Hell, I can talk to my head swell up that big. Unless it was there. And I sure didn't put it there. We are so immature that we don't want to esteem others more highly than us. That's a stupid beast. We should esteem others. We are silly jackasses. We don't even... We don't even have the courage to esteem others. We don't have the mentality to esteem them higher than you. I don't want to compare myself with him. No man. I appreciate the gifts of a man, his beauty. Because I have no insecurities as to the strength and the beauty of a man. Because he has poured out many gifts among Yisrael. And a man's gift, his own gift will make room for him. You don't have to talk about it. People will know about it. People will see it. We need the gifts of Yah in this hour. We need the gifts of his wisdom of men that when they enter a place, people say, who is that man? Where is he from? When they see their Ishaw, they say, wow, who is that? And they are astonished. And in awe. That's why no woman is going to run me. No woman. Well, I'll leave. Go to hell. Leave. Hallelujah. For you have said in your love, I will ascend, I will allow into the Shemaim. I will exalt my kese, my throne, my wisdom, my authority of power, my own dignity, above the kochav, the stars of Almighty Yahweh. I will sit also in the mountain of the Moed place, Isaiah 14:13, in the side of Yah's prominent place. And this is the catalyst here in verse 14. He again implies, I will Allah, I will ascend above the Bama, above the heights of Yah's superiority, above his strength, his beauty, his excellence. I will ascend above the heights of the high place. The mind of Yahshua that we shall let, as Shaul said, be in us. Let this same mind that was in Yahshua HaMashiach, you allow those principles to be the power of your direction. In any way you go, you will always resort to the principles of the Ruach HaKodesh. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. And he says this. This is what the Shadim of your mind, the demon forces that you placate, your emotions, your feelings, your attitude. I will be lack. I will be dama. I will be in the same similitude. I will have the same power. I will have the same understanding and wisdom. Nahash says, the day you defy Yah, the day Ahava, the day that Hava, the day that you defy Yah, you will become a god. You will allow Nahash to be your dictate. You will elect what is right. You will say what is wrong. You will say what is perfect. You will declare. That's why this is a nation that say a damn faggot dog is all right. A nation that says a butch bull dagger whore is all right. A nation that tell the women that dress like a 2-cent whore is all right. A nation that tell the men to wear them skinny tighter like a fag of a freak is all right. A nation that teaches your women to rebel. A nation that teaches your men to be abusive with no kind of a hava for the woman. They exploit them like a dirty piece of a whore. That's what comes from this Nahashia. Stupid men that have no gravity of the excellence of Yah. That they are emotionally driven and they're going to die that way too. And tell them one other day, you better prepare to die. Prepare, as the old folks would say, to meet Almighty Yahweh. I don't take a dumb thing back. I don't care if he or she are offended at me. You played around too long. You know you played around too long. You know how? Because you have not progressed. You're the same as you were today as you were a year ago, 2 years ago, 10 years. You become even worse than you were then. So I'm not taking anything back. You're worse than when you were a boy. You might as well love me. You got to love me if you got into the kingdom. Hallelujah. I will be Lot. I will be Dama. I will have the same similitude. I will resemble Almighty Yah. I will be one that you will have considered. He said, I will be like the Most High. So when a man begins to change the diction of Torah and the dictates of Torah, he is saying that I am Allah. I have extended to that place. I have the power to do that. I have the power to determine what is the value and what is not. It is a self-absorbed exhortation that doesn't even know, the man doesn't even know how, the woman, how to receive accolades. He's a beautiful brother. When you say that, most men just hum and say, yes. Oh, react, don't do that. I watch the ones I've exalted here. You know what happens? That's why I don't do much exaltation. They act like fools. Act like fools. They have not learned how to be appeased. And they're not humble. That's why this mind of this nation. There's some things I'm going to read. I am going to read. I'll do it next week. These pompous, wicked, damn minds. You see all that red?
These are the nations that have the nuclear power to burn your babies,
yes.
To burn you,
yes.
To devastate your fields to produce, to cause. Look at those nations. You don't see anything on that continent of death. You see it in this wicked whore. This in black, you see it in these wicked holes. And these nations are nations under the watch guidance of these, what they call superpowers. You have 11,000 nuclear bombs. That is a massive destruction in Russia. We're not talking about the ones that can be fired from a grenade launcher or even in bullets, what they did in Iraq. And then these United Snakes out of hell have nearly 9,000, 8,500. Have enough weapons to destroy this world over 1,000 times. And they're mad in their damn mind because they are wicked. These are wicked men. They are wicked men. You have been brought up under the adjudication of their laws and their corruption. And so you think you're somebody. And so how does one cool? How does one survive in the midst of such devastating calamity? Are you going to the stores to survive? It won't be. Are you going to buy bread? There will be no bread to buy. Are we going to be able to survive off the land? The land shall be in turmoil. It shall weep from its depths. The ocean shall rage and cry. And the stench of the oceans and the sea will be nothing compared unto Mizraim. It shall groan, it shall toss to and fro, waiting for the power of its maker. It shall. So how shall we cool? How shall we maintain? How shall we sustain ourselves? How shall we be contained when the great agony of great death and the stench of death is all around you, Yisrael? How do you do that? Because it's one thing that Evangelist Hartsfield taught me 30-some years ago. I was not one to talk. I was one to listen. And a wise man always listen. He said to me, son, don't you ever forget this. There is no weapon of time that has ever been built that man has not used it. Ponder that. Ma, that's what he would talk to me.
Right.
I didn't say, what do you mean? I just, even when I didn't understand it, I just rested in that. And then as Yah matured me by hearing, I could understand it even in a greater depth. Yisrael. So this is the constitution of Nahash that says, I will burn this damn place down to the ground. That's what Hashatan says. That's what the mind of his mindset, that is the mind of Hashatan. The mind of America is the mind of Hashatan. It is the mind of Nahash. It goes about exploiting and destroying the people that have no power. They're cowards. They can't fight. They have no resolve to say, let's go fist to fist. So they burn your damn babies. They pull them out of your womb, mama. They tell you to abort, and you're so damn dumb and stupid, you do it. They burn your babies in the womb. They kill them, your sons. But it's one thing, they have never gotten a true zero of Israel. When Pharaoh said, damn it, kill them all. But the wives that were of Abram, the Hebrew wives, they would say the women were too feisty. They could not. They did not kill the sons. Why? Because the man is of great strength. These damn jackasses are boys today. They're coward little boys. The emotion of freaks. Emotion of freaks, what they are. They gyrate. My oldest brother, he's dead. He says to me one day, and although he turned against the simple knowledge that he knew at that time, he would always say to me, baby boy, and of course, here I'm 250 pounds, but little man, I should be calling you baby boy. I'm strong as a bull, but I did not dishonor my eldest brother. He would say this to me all the time, baby boy, don't vacillate. He said, don't be a pancake. Don't flip and flop here today and tomorrow over there. Flip and flopping and flopping and flipping. Those simple words that he spoke to me gave me balance, not to be a damn hypocrite. Not to be a hypocrite. Can I preach a little bit? I shall, my friend. A time of great agony, the judgment of Yah. And so Hashatan says, I will supersede. I will build the fires. You know I understand the depths of aerodynamics. I will make men ascend into the heavens and they will fly. Yah says, I'm the one that created the mathematical equation. I know you did. Because I was the covering, I know. You think that Yah is some kind of physical individual that sits on a ketseya? Yah is Ruach. Yah is Ruach. Yah is Ruach. His life is the substance of life, his breath. And everything you see is Yah. On the moving of that leaf out there, the movement of the grass, that's Yah. He blows and the grass moves. He blows from the nostril or his ruach. And he was the covering of Yah's great kesey. And the wisdom of just standing there being quiet emanated. Yeah, I know you created, but you know what I know. And Yah says to him, do your thing. Well, I don't believe that. He says, have you considered my servant Eob? I want to be a man like that. All those men that counseled Eob, they were as wise as him. They sat, listen, you do your study and you understand. They will sit in the market with his father. And young men would gather around when they would hear the sound of their voices. You don't shut up the power of this truth and hide it. They would sit in the marketplace and they would talk, and men would hear them talk, and they would hear their words, and they would gravitate and listen. Ooh, wow, he said that. I don't care if you don't like me, you don't even love you. If you don't love me, because you haven't learned how to love you. Yah commands you to love your neighbor as you love yourself. So do you allow yourself to correct you? Do you allow yourself to correct you? Were we not told on Cathay Imata, if we would correct ourselves, if we would discipline our own selves? A fool likes no kind of correction. A fool doesn't like to be exposed. A fool doesn't want anyone to speak to him or her because they know everything. And they don't, because if they knew the wisdom of Yah, they would rejoice. It's ah, bless you, Yah. Hallelujah. I'm not afraid of any man when it comes to this. Hallelujah. I'm not afraid of any man when it comes to this. I'm not afraid of your segregation from me. You would never work with me. They were among us, but they were never of us. I want to give you an illustration. I know I read this, but I want to read it again in the book of Job. I want to point out some things here again. I think they're vital. Joel. I want to point them out. There is only one way we are going to survive in this hour, Yisrael, that we're going to have the Nsarah, the ability to escape. Job chapter 1, verse 14. That this is what Yah says. I want you to hear this precisely. In the book of Joel. It says not E-L, but it's A-L-E, Joel. In the book of Joel, Job, it says this in chapter 1, verse 14. I want to precisely go over the wording because it's important. If you miss one of the most vital verbs in the sentence, you miss the very beautiful word of what it's trying to express. As I explained this over the many years, you that have been with me, you've heard it. When Evangelist Hartsfield he was reading one day, I went in his bedroom as we had prepared him a beautiful place. When he was traveling to rest his weary feet, he could come and stay at our home of no charge. And he was down one morning praying and reading. He says, come here, Brother Robertson. And he was reading. He said, read that, explain that. Well, I made myself look like a young jackass, which I was. He said, read it again and explain it. Well, the second time I was more careful because I knew I was way off mark. He said, read it again. And I read it again. He says, now when you read it this time, look at this word. When I read it, it was like the, I began to rejoice because I knew then. And then when I explained it at the time, he said, yes. That's the way he would do things. Well, how were you able to do it? Because I've always been able to listen and submit myself. I've always been able to submit. That's one of the strongest pursuits of any marriage, submitting yourself unto one another in the fear of Yah. Wife, know your place. Husband, know your place. And then wife, you become subject unto your husband. He is the final arbiter. Whatever decision he makes, shut your damn mouth and be quiet. You may not understand how he has interpreted your counsel, but he has heard it. He has submitted himself unto that to listen, to hear. And then he said, no, this is what we're going to do. And once he says that, shut up. Women don't think I love Yah. I don't like them. One writes me, us today. With great respect, you are wrong. I write her back, with no respect, you are wrong. First of all, you are a woman, you will not instruct nor correct me in any matter. These little weak men would say, well, they try to take time to explain. Well, sister, I always shut. No. Shut your mouth. You need to learn how to be quiet. I like this man. He helps me a lot. Iyob, chapter 1, verse 14. First of all, he said, set apart. Kadosh. Set apart, he says, a sum, a fast. A time whereby you reject all things. Not only the food, the biological need of your body, but those things that keep you separated from Yah, your thoughts, your emotions, your feelings. Isn't that what got the best of us, our feelings? We allow our feelings to flare up, our attitude, to announce what we really are. And you can tell what one is by their attitude. He says, set apart a fast, and I want you to call. He used the word called kara, speak aloud. He said, call a mikrah kodash, call a meeting. Whereby you will not inject your emotions, your feelings. Whereby you will not allow your sensual activities to supersede the Torah of Yah. He said, I want you to call a meeting. And then he commands us, he says, I want you to gather. I think that word is, it means more than just gather. It means putting them out, putting those out, putting that one out. I have to research that word again. I may be wrong. No, don't write me and tell me. I'm a student. He said, gather, listen to what he says. He said, gather the zachin, zachinha. I want to give you some, I want to give you one. I wrote this down here. Yeah, in my handwriting. I want to give you a simple synopsis of what is Zachin and his power. Listen to this. He did not say call for the prayer warriors. He said call for the Zachin. Call. He uses the word kara. Let it flow from your bellies. Let the sound of the alarm waffle throughout the mountains, the high places. He said call for the gathering of the Zachin. Zachin. Plural. The many. He said, call for the gathering of the Zachin. Now, this is what a Zachin is. It's not by his talk. This is what it says about. I define this. You can define it in the Ethiopic, in the Aramaic, of the Hebraic language. But this is what an elder. This is one of the simple identities of an elder. He did not tell you to call for the babies. He said, call. Kara. Cry out. Don't have anything to cause you to resist the cry. Kara is when you talk so loud, your jugular veins explode. My bad. I search things like a tenacious treasure hunter. I just don't read. Sometimes you may not see me, you think I'm sleeping. I don't like to do that because I can't go to sleep at night. So I'm not sitting around napping. And when I have time to study, whether I'm laboring, whether I'm working, I go in the house, in my bed. If it's nothing but 20 minutes for this moment, I'm not looking to see what attributes of things I can add to this. I want to understand that one thing. You understand? So you were not dealing with a boy, an immature individual that goes by one's synopsis and read it, and they want to talk about it. It's almost like a kid getting a new toy and they want to tell everybody got a new toy. That's not what a master of Torah does. A man that can master the wisdom of Torah, he doesn't do it that way. Listen to this. He says, I want you to call for the Zakein. Now, this is how Zakein is recognized. This is what it says. This is not my verbiage. It says, a Zakein, one recognized by Yisrael, the people, for his gifts. For the great gifts. When someone sees LeBron James, they can look at his physical body and tell that he is some kind of athlete. Cannot they do that? Sure you can. You can see the gift in him. When you see a woman that you can say, she's got to be a model. You can tell a model from just a pretender. Can you not? Sure you can. You can tell a pretty woman that her beauty is just not because her nose may be flared like my nose, but she's still pretty. That doesn't mean she's that pretty. Her hair may be what the world calls as nappy as Cooter Brown. How many of y'all heard of that Cooter Brown? She got that finger up my Zake. That's what we would say. That had nappy as Cooter Brown. Maybe nappy as Cooter Brown, but that doesn't mean that she is not. There was a young lady that we all knew, my Ishona. Her name was Trina Rowling. She was black as tar. She was black. But she had a sophistication about her that she was a pretty gal. She was so black. Her son went on to play football for UCLA. I knew her husband. We went to school together. And then he played for the Carolina Panthers, running back. But she was black as that blouse a haute blonde has on. She was black. But there was an essence of her beauty that the oils that flowed through her, it was different. So a gift, a Zakein is recognized by the people. He doesn't recognize himself. He is recognized, she is recognized by the people for his gifts of leadership. For his gifts of leadership, they can lead. How many men can take a people in the midst of a torrid rainstorm of death and fear, can guide them by their strength? They don't have a damn thing. They lead by their leadership, wisdom, and they're men that are full of justice. Their words are just. You know, he said to us, it's amazing how that we can always speak against our ach and our hot. We don't ever speak against ourselves. We can see where there are fallacies and where they're wrong, but you will never tell nobody where you're wrong. You will never tell because you're a damn weak coward. You're a weak coward. We must prepare our minds. We must arad. We must school. We must survive. I'm going to give us some wonderful words today. Don't worry. That's what Yah says. He says, you call for those that have leadership. You call for those that have wisdom when they talk. Even the children look at them and they listen. You call for those that they understand. You can see it. You can see it in the vortex of their frontal lobe. You can see it. And when they hear from matter, they know how to answer it wisely. They speak the mishli or the parables of the Torah. And they bring such essence of truth and revelation that even in the midst of your greatness of agony and pain, you rise up as a warrior with the sword of the ruach drawn. He said, call for the elders. Hell, they are not elders to call for today. I'm just being honest. I know that Zakein means those of old age, but it also implies those that have experienced life. And above all things, oh woman, you hear me? This is what a Zakein, a mother, an ima is. This is, you will know that they are elders. You will know about this clarification of the Torah or the Hebraic idiom of a Zakein says, they are always satisfied with life. Yeah. Yeah. It's in the book. Yeah. I didn't define it. They're always satisfied with life. Always. I don't care what the trial is, they're always satisfied. That's what it means. I search deep. You got to search a whole lot of scriptures to find it, but I search it. Always satisfied with life. I don't care what situation around. No, I don't care in the midst of the toils. I don't care in the midst of the great agony of trial. They're always. Thank you, Yahweh. Thank you, Yahweh. Thank you, Yahweh, for all the trials. You know you brought me through them, and you established my going. I wanted to die for another day. They have such robust appreciation of life. That's why Yah says, call for the Zakim. They have an appreciation for life. They have a robustness of life. And they can make you appreciate the very ordeal that is about to transpire. That's why he did not say call. We can see in Torah where one was the name of Rehoboam. He ascended to the throne of his avats, Shlomo. And so he had all these young hair around him. And yet the elders, the council of the elder, gave him counsel. You can't be so hard. Your damn attitude cannot be hard. You got to get that damn crazy look off of your head. You got to smile. He said, I'm warning you, boy, and be light on the people. Don't be so damn hard on them. Don't be so grandizing and so willing to fight. We fight to defend Yah's emunah, his truth. And so he went to the jackass young boys and they said, hell no. Grind them down. And the whole house, all the labor that David had done, the house was scattered and broken. So that's why he said, call for the Zachin, the elderly women who have seen the testimony of the husband, of the man. They've seen the beauty of his strength. They've seen the actions and the activities of his will, his chofetz, what pleases him before you. They've seen that. They've seen the maturity of his mind shine forth from the countenance of his panim, his expression. You can tell a dumb man by the way he looks. You go somewhere and you want about somewhere, you want about something, say, huh? They don't know. A man is saying, oh, certainly, sir, come on. I will, man, that I shall do. But a damn dumb man, he'll go. Catch me some fish, man. Hallelujah. That's right, Toda. Yeah. Call for the elders. Gather the Zachin. And then he says, all the inhabitants. He did not just say Yisrael. He uses the word Geh. Those that have been born under the right of the constitution of the Torah. He said, gather all the inhabitants into the land where you gather them. He says in Habeat, the Beit, the house of Yah. Hallelujah. You gather them in the house of Yah. You gather them in Yah's house. You gather them in the bosom of Yahshua HaMashiach. You gather them in the testimony of that power. And we must do that. And the testimony of that power is not how you talk. It's how you walk, man. And then when you talk, they will say, I've never heard a man like that. You know the way I used to walk. Oh, don't walk no more since Yahshua brought me to Yah. You know the way I used to talk. I don't talk no more since Yah lay Yahshua in my mind. Oh, you know the things I used to do. I don't do no more. The way I used to treat you, I will not do it because Yahshua, oh, Yahshua is in my mind. Yah is God in me. Oh, you know the way I used to act. I don't act no more since the Torah filled my mind. Oh, you, the things I used to say. The way I treated you, oh, I don't go that way. Oh, Yahshua HaMashiach, guards me day and night. When I rise, I shout hallelujah all the way. I used to walk, oh, I don't walk no more. Hallelujah. I like that.
Listen to the truth. He said, call for them in the bed of Yah. He says, and this is what I want you to do. He says, I want you to za'ak, not kara. I want you to cry. He said, I want you to cry for the help of Yah. That's the beauty of an elder. When you find him with nothing to do, he would be before Yah crying out, praying. That's a fact, Yisra'ya. He said that, call them to cry for the help of Yah. I'm in need of your help, Yah. I need you. He said, call them to the help of Yah. He says, Allah, he said, my people for Chayam, the day of Yah. And then he says it again, for the day of Yah is at Yad, it's at hand. It's within the hand breath. You can feel it. You can touch it. You can lay hold onto it. And he commands the Zakein, those that have the gift of wisdom and knowledge, that men will inquire of their knowledge. They will ask of their wisdom. They will want to sit in the market to inquire of their wisdom. And the breath of the Ruach of that wisdom, it's scattered abroad. Just like someone cooking a certain kind of food. They cook it so they want the fragrance to go out everywhere. That's what they do. And that perfume which is contained in the bottle, once you spray it on, then everyone, oh, that smells so wonderful. Come on, you got a free, sweet fragrance of the life of Yahshua in you? You want everybody to know it. Yeah. And you tell them, you advertise. In order for you to get your product out, you must advertise, don't you? So that's how you advertise your statehood and your manhood by the way you walk, the way you look, the way you dress, the way your mind is dressed. No other damn way. Does a whore do that? Does a pimp of a faggot man do the same? You will know it. He said, cry to Yah, for the day of Yah is at hand. He tells us it's a day of destruction. It's a day of Shod. It's a day of Shamath. It's a day of Ibrah. Destruction, the fire of Yah's anger. And no one is going to survive. He says that the day of Shod, there shall be great oppression, surmising. No man will be able to trust any man. That's why we can only trust one man. And that is the man of Yahshua that dwells in us. Listen! You're shaking your damn wicked heads like you know something. You don't even trust him. We all come on. Because if you trust him, you will not walk repeatedly doing the same damn thing we do. Y'all don't trust no man, you jackass. You will know that man. It will be the living power of his testimony. So when you meet that which is of the Bohir, the chosen, you will know they will not guard you wrong. They will not bring you into devastation. We think, yeah, that's right, trust no man, because we think we can trust us. The hidden man of your heart is wicked. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Whose heart, yours or mine? My heart. Your own damn heart deceives you. No man deceive you. You deceive yourself to think you're somebody. You deceive yourself with your own damn lies, because I'm not telling you you're great. So you tell yourself, I'm great. I got the wisdom of Yah's word. You can't even enunciate anything. How are you great? I'm putting all you Zakein, you three on the spot, because we're going to bring you up here soon. You can't get by with me. You put me on the spot. I'm on the spot all the time. Your words will be the combination of your actions and your activities. What you say doesn't mean a damn thing unless there's the visibility there. So we ought not to be so anxious for things that we don't understand the concept and the depth of it. My judgment is not going to be like maybe her judgment. I want you to judge me. Everything I say. How are you all doing out there?
Ak Davis, huh? You got him quiet there. I know you do. My Zachin Davis, he said, I make him shut up. But wait after the preacher finished this riach. Ah, he's listening. He says, the day of sure of great violence and destruction ruined. Who is it from? Is it from the devil or from the Most High? This is from Almighty Yahweh. He says, from the most powerful shall it come. That little four-letter word, shall it boo. It shall enter in, it shall proceed, it shall go forth by Almighty Yahweh. Listen to this. He says, in that day is not the meat. Yahshua says, I have meat to eat that you know not of. You don't understand the meat I eat. And then to reconstitute them at the last of his Pesach, he says, take, eat, for my body is meat indeed. No, it was no cannibalism, this stupid generation. We must understand the lachem. What was the meat for? It was for the offering. It was for the offering. It was for the offering, the zebach. The zebach or the zerach. It was for the offering unto Yah. He said, I am the offering. I am the perfect offering. So you consume the refreshing of Torah. You eat this word. You eat the Torah of Yah. He says, for it's not the meat or the ochel, not only the offering for our sins, not only that, but it's not the food supply. It's not the ochel cut off. Do you understand the logistics of great devastation in the land, the roads destroyed? How do you transport food? Who's going to work the fields? Who's going to do that, Yisrael? When people are sickly and dying, every kind of disease, when the gates of hell have been opened and they shot them, the demons of every kind of attack, their minds, their bodies, their will, their purpose, there is no pleasure in that. You imagine the flies there, Mr. Rahim. You think they were just sitting around? You know what it is with a few flies around here. And the stench of death and the dead frogs and all of that coming in the dead firstborn and the stench permeated over the land. Can you imagine the death and the smell of death? Who's burying them? But it was not found in Goshen, among Yah's people. How are we going to survive the nuclear holocaust? We need the Zachin. We need wise men with the gift of Yah's wisdom, the gift of Yah's justice, the gift of Yah's judgment, the gift of Yah's character and his characteristics. We don't need stupid damn old men that are stupid and jackass and immature. We need mature men. And I'm not going to stop using the superlatives, the noun, the verbs that I use. If I offend you, I'm glad I offend you. Glad I offend you, because you offended Almighty Yah. You purport yourself and identify yourself with this manner of a man, and you're not even close to that proximity. What if I got up here every Shabbat and told jokes and all that kind of folly? You know, you have never heard me tell a joke from here. I've never been a damn clown. I don't do things to make you laugh. And when someone is talking to you, they always got to, you know, that's a damn clown. When I talk to you, I'm sober and I'm sound. That's what the Zakeh must be. He must be sober and sound. He can't be a damn fool. So when he cried the alarm, the people will hear. Get into the house. They don't question what he says. Well, hold up now. I got to bake my bread, baby. Hold up now. I got to wash my hair. Get my clothes on. My prayer, raise up the Nobi, the prophet, the messenger. Raise up the Nevi'im, the mighty men. Hell, you wouldn't even know one if he came. You can't receive this simplicity of truth. You can't obey this. You think you're going to obey a prophet? He's going to kill you. Oh, he's coming to kill. When the Nobi is raised up, when the true men, not these little boys out here to call themselves prophets and Shulishim or apostles. These are boys. These are real little juvenile boys. They're boys. They have no knowledge of Torah. They hear someone else say something, they say it. I had a man call me yesterday. Why don't I ask you a question about the name and the enunciation and all that? I said, first of all, sir, hold up. I say, how many websites have you looked at about the name? Well, I've looked at several. I've looked at many. I say, then so you're going to deduct from what one answer you according to your liking or not. Then you shall choose what is properly fitting for you. Is that right? Oh, well, somewhat. Yeah. I said, well, then look on our website. Just read first. And then when you call me back again or you listen to me preach, well, I thought you were that handsome. I said, hold up, boy. I said to my issue, I said, and the first thing he would say, that I'm rude and I'm crude. And he was a damn fool. He didn't see his damn folly, his stupidity. That meant, okay, I'll take an hour to explain. No, I'm not taking an hour to explain for this man, because I knew exactly what he was trying to do. He was trying to maneuver his own course. I said, you didn't call me for just that reason. If you call me, my friend, if you're led by the, well, I'm led by the Holy Ghost. I said, well, hell, I'm not led by the Holy Ghost. I said, if you were led by the Ruach HaKodesh, once you call me, you know it stopped right there. I'm not bashful to say that. Not at all. You don't have to look any further. Stand still and see the salvation of our Abba. You've done all you did, searching. Just stand still. Listen to this man. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He says that destruction shall come from him. Is not the meat, in verse 16, is not the meat karat? Is it not cut off? The meat offering to Yah? We don't offer Yah no meat offering. Hell, we cut. You understand what the burnt offering, the whole of the burnt offering? It was the culmination. Zacchaeus taught on that to us. This fire of Yahweh consumed the meat offering, even with Elijah. How that, he says, get your damn gods, and I tell you what, wet this and do all you want to, but that's all right. When the offering is pleasing to Yah, he will consume it. So when the meat offering is cut off, we have no ability to offer unto Yah. So the reason that we come before Yah with this damned kind of false Todah, we just may say, Todah. Now, we don't say Todah to Yah. We should enter into his presence with Todah and singing and dancing. We come like damn fools. Yes, you do. We come with nothing of essence. We come with no enthusiasm unto Yah. See, the meat offering is cut off already. Wasn't the meat offering unto Yah? So the meat offering come up. You think you got meat. You think you got knowledge of the Torah. When a man got that knowledge, he, whoa, yeah. I don't feel like it. I don't care about my feelings. He dances in the Ruach of Yah. He has strength. That is his strength. Doesn't meat make you stronger? Come on, there's nothing like some fried chicken. I don't want no baked chicken. I want fried chicken. I want fried fish. That's right. I want fried chicken. Nothing like it. I don't want no cream potatoes. What's better for you? Well, I mean, fried potatoes. No cream. I don't want to eat every day, but when I get some chicken, I want it fried. Once a month, give me some fried chicken. Eat fish, won't give me fried. I don't want it every day now. No. I've always loved me. I've always known how to take care of myself. I don't want it every day. Yah didn't command them to offer an offering every day. So the meat offering is karach. It is eviscerated. It is removed. There's no thought of that. We don't even think, as a nation of people, we don't even think, well, we offer unto Yah. It's so sad. When LeBron James is thumping there in that arena, and he's boop. When Kobe comes to town, hell, those that are poor go out to see it. That's a fact. Yet when Yah says two or three gathered in my name, there shall I be in the midst. Nobody comes out to see him speaking. We don't come in, hallelujah, hallelujah. Folks go down to the jam joint, whole house. Shoom, boom, 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 shoom. Oh, whoa, babe, woo, what's up, player? What's up, dog? They want everybody to see them. Got their grab, just got it out of the dry cleaners that evening. What's up, dog? Hey, how you doing? Everything straight? I've been around, okay? I've been around a bit. All right. I wasn't born yesterday. I've been around. Okay. I was born yesterday. I've been out a little while. Okay. I've been out of the womb a little bit. Hallelujah. It's a day of destruction from Almighty Yah. The meat is cut off before our Uzzin, our eyes. And he says, look, see, you know you have no meat offering. Listen to this in verse 16. Yes, yes, yes. Even the shimcha, the mirth of Yah's beauty. Is that not cut off from Yisrael, Yah? We don't have no beauty in our joy with Yah. Anytime Yah corrects us, he's showing us love. And when anyone doesn't love correction, that's a fool. It is. It's one thing when you deal with a wise man or a woman, when the hearts are pure. The word tacha, clean from all external activities that circumvent them. Does it say this to us? To the pure, all things are pure. Even if you speak to them about a thing that they're not guilty of, they see the purity of it. It gives them balance. Not a damn fool. To the pure, all things are pure. But to those that are, to me, defiled, and unbelieving, there is nothing pure. There is nothing to have. Not to hold, but to have. There's nothing right. When they defile, when they don't believe Yah. He gave gifts unto men. Not boys, but he gave gifts unto men. All things are pure, Yisrael. So whether you speak to him that is ill or ill reproach he perceives, he still understands the purity. Whether does she understand that? Hallelujah. He says the meat offering is cut off before our eyes. Yes, Shimcha, joy and gila, gladness from the bed of Yah. Did we come in here dressed glad to go? Did we come in here dressed in the cloth or in the garment of Sadiq? He said, yes, even the gila, the gladness of Yah. He says, it is cut off from the house of Yah. He said, even the zira, the word that goes forth, the seed of Yah's word. Hear me. Joel 1:17, he said, even the seed, it is abash, it is rotten. It is dried up. The seed of our mind is rotten. Our thoughts are rotten. Our ways. And you tell me the five Yah's not going to come to extricate himself and to eradicate the spirit. The enemy is going to try to use the nuclear bomb to destroy the people of Yah. But there is tikvah. There's hope. There's promise. And when Yah says promise, he's talking about his dabarim. The words that he speaks. That is the promise. Everything he speaks is a promise. Everything is wrong. Whether it is to judge us, to correct us, or to raise us up, Yisrael. He said his seed is run under the clock, and the utzah, the garner, the barns, your treasure, where you store your treasures. Well, where you store the treasures of your wickedness? Right here, don't you? He said even the barns, the utzah, the barns, the storehouse, they are laid to show meem. They are laid to desolate. There's nothing there. There's nothing of riches. When you find a house that is desolate, there's no rich treasure in that house. When you find a zakein, an elderly woman or elderly man, who when they speak, their knowledge is not so enriching that you want to just listen to them all day, there's nothing there. They're empty. They have nothing. And that's a fact. He said the barns are broken down and the corn is yabesh. It has withered away, Yisrael. It has withered away. There's no life in their substance, in their meat offering. There's nothing there. Hallelujah. Well, Yah showed me this in the scripture. He showed you need to judge you. That's why he showed you. Because you don't possess that. And you think you possess it, but you don't possess it. That's why he showed you. I was reading that. Yeah, he showed you that. That's why when I spoke it was meant to judge you. And show you're lacking.
Yeah.
Yah says, how does the beast, and that's what a beast does, that spirit of Nahash, it groans. When Yah says groan, he is saying, when that spirit of Nahash, when you attack that damn beast, it's always going to recoil. You can't go out there and grab that bull and think he's not going to recoil. You think you can? He said, the beasts, they groan. How the beasts groan? The herd of the cattle, they are perplexed. They're so confused. They don't know. Why? Because there is no place. There is no pasture. There is no re'ach. That's what the word re'ach means. One that guides one to the pastures to eat. He say, and the flock of the Sun, are we not the sheep of Yah, the Sun? Are we not the sheep of Yah? Yoel now. Turn to Yoel. Reading from that book, Yoel. Hallelujah. Turn to Yoel. It says, and the sheep or the flock of the sheep, Yoel, chapter 1, verse 19, the book of Joel 1:19. He says, oh yeah. See what he says? He says, to you will I cry, will I cry. Yeah. Why? For the fire of your judgment, the fire of your word, the places that you've been healing from, Yah's trying to destroy that. He's trying to cause you to abandon that place. You know, you don't have life in you. He said, the fire has devoured the pastures of the wilderness or the Bimetbar. You can hide nowhere. Yeah. Eyo. Joel 1:19. He says, and the flame, the flame, the noor, that which shine. Did not Jeremiah says that the word, the Torah of Yah, is like fire shut up in his bones? See, when we as Zachin get that fire of Yah's passion, you can't tell when a fire's burning. You know, I can look out of my bedroom and tell when the fire's dying down in the stove because it's got a little glass front. Whoa, time to get up. Just a reflection. So when you got the fire of Yah burning out of you, you tell me it's unrecognizable. We got sin burning in us. We got wickedness. Our hearts are vile and corrupt. That's what it is. He said, it's just like fire. Oh, shut up. In my bones. I can't hold this back. And when the fire's rolling, you got to run, baby. You got to find the place whereby you can be comforted. He says, a flame, the flame of Yah, has burned not some, but all the trees. We think that that is just a natural ezrek. That's what a tree is, an ezrek, or an ezer. You think that, what do you mean? He talks about Dinat Zakin. Yaramaya brings out to us how that his word is like a fire that it consumes the fires or the trees of Lebanon, the fir trees of Lebanon. What was he talking about? You think he was talking about just a tree, or was he talking about the fire of his word? Or those trees representing nations of people? Strong people that have exalted themselves and think they're stronger and mightier than Yah. That's what he was talking about. He said that the Father's word has consumed the trees of the field. Verse 20. He says, the beast, Nahash, the spirit of the field, cries also to Yah, why Yah, for the rivers, for the Yam, the water passage, the rivers. For the rivers of water, of Mayam. He said, they are Yabish, they're dried up. There's no living water. There shall be a famine. We have a famine. It's not for eating your bread. We eat more bread than any nation. Yeah. We're fat. We're out of shape. We have no strength. We're lazy. We eat. Not for the eating of bread, but the shemach, of the hearing. Not just, but the hearing of. The hearing of the word of Almighty Yah. He said, the beasts of the field cry also to Yah, for the rivers of water are dried up, and the fire has devoured the pastures of the wilderness. They cry, but there is no help. Who shall redeem? How are we going to cool, to maintain, to contain, to survive, to sustain? In an hour at a time, when Yah unleashes his judgment, don't you understand that when America dropped the bombs on Iraq, When they dropped the napalm bombs there in Vietnam, when they burned the babies that were naked in their clothing, when they lost 50,000 soldiers there because of their own damn greed, it was not to bring a constitution democracy to Vietnam. It was for the damn greedy bastards, the dogs, those that hold back the wages of the workers by default to their own destruction. She did not go into Iraq to free the people there in great abundance. No, than when the Mr. Saddam Hussein was in power. She did not go there for that. She went to rob her for history and to take her riches, to take the art and all of her riches, and to take her damn all of what she did. They don't care about the people. This is a nation that was raised up on injustice. A constitution did not give a damn about any man, but what we call the white man. And that is the entrenched mentality in this nation. You got a problem with that because you got sin in you. Hell, that's why all white men think they know everything. It's a white mind. Y'all listen to the message. I'm not going to stop talking like this. I don't care how bright some man is, they think they know anybody. And if you offended at that because you got that damn mess in you, I don't care who you are. I don't give a damn. Damn white people. Damn black people. I love the people of Yah. You defend any kind of whiteness, it's wrong. And that's what a white mind, it cannot handle a mind that rejects its porous lies and subjugate one to that. I don't give a damn if you feel uncomfortable with me, because you got the trash in you. That's a fact. That's exactly what it is. Gaon, pride, hubris. Hallelujah. And it's wrong. It's wrong. I don't care what it is coming from. It's wrong. That's not what Yah ordained. It's wrong. It's wrong. It's wrong. For that is the mind that has dictated and predicated everything when it comes to what we call religion. They give you a damn little freak faggot Jesus. I don't give a damn how color you want to paint him. He's still a white Jesus. I said to a man that called me, he got offended at me. I said, man, instead of you fighting against me, fight against the lies out there. Fight against the damn white Jesus and all the lies that are out there. You getting upset with me? Or you sounding like a Louis Farrakhan? I said, I don't sound like no Louis Farrakhan. I sound like a messenger of truth. Yeah. And I'm dealing with your damn sins and you can't handle that. Well, I'm a fifth generation of a Jew. I say, I have no problem with you being a Jew, but that doesn't mean you are the son of Abraham, because he had another son that they are not of the Zira of the blessing. And we're so afraid to talk like that. If that offends you because you need to get stuff out of you, then talk to me like that. Tell me what's in me that's impeding me and holding me back. Show me. You can never be an excellent athlete if someone say, well, he's excellent, but no, you're weak. You need to get in the gym. You need to do that. I was thinking this morning, when I was a young kid, I played every sport. I was an excellent tennis player. We didn't have those big racks called the head. We had them little racks in my days. I played tennis. I ran track. I played baseball. Every sport. I don't care what it was. I tried soccer. You name it. Golf. Man, I could drive. Brothers right here didn't think the preacher could drive a car. I said, okay, I'm going to drop it over there. Now watch this, huh? It got me a 9-iron. It's why? Because that's all we did when I was growing up. We couldn't go to the links. Let's get real and let's deal with the things that are handicapping us as a nation. And dividing the people of Yah. I'm not going to apologize for that, Yisrael. We must understand that. Hallelujah. And so no matter of any other nationality of differences, when he says something, well, it doesn't equate to what he says. You're a damn liar. I will deal with any man. I can stand with the strongest of them. I'm going to L.A. and I want the boys to come. My message shall be Esav, the nation, the people, the mind. That's all right. That's just stir up a little controversy. And I'm going to stir up controversy. I'm going to stir it up. I'm going to stir up controversy. You hear me out there, Azakhin, David? You hear me? I'm coming to stir up controversy. Oh, agree to disagree with, then you're a weak coward. I don't agree with you, period. We just flat out disagree. What's wrong with that? Well, you think I've never, my wife hasn't, you've never disagreed with me all these years we've been together. That doesn't mean I separate from her, because we disagree, silly people. Hallelujah. Is there a constitution for us? Sure it is. We'll work on that a little bit. Next week, and maybe the next week. It is all in the line of Nahash, this one that shall rise up against Yah, this anti-Hamashiach spirit. That's what it is. It is impregnated by a mind of superiority. I was listening to Mr. Romney yesterday. He was talking about how superior America is. I said, what an arrogant bastard. And yet their nations, as we want to call culture, and their, and what they have added to what we call culture, this nation hasn't added one thing but how to kill, how to steal, how to enslave, how to celebrate a victory over people that had bows and arrows. And they call it Thanksgiving Day. And they sit down and eat hog feet and got you eating the damn chitlins and the hog feet. That's not a superior mind. A superior mind always elevates a person. If your mind is superior, it always bring enlightenment to someone. It always strengthens them. It always elevates them. This nation has killed and robbed and stole. And we defend that. I will not defend it. This place is not right because there are black folks here, white folks here. It's right because the Ruach of Yah said, damn white people, black people. It's not right because you're here. Because you're black or you're white. It's right because he is our Yashah. He is the Yashah. He sets things straight and in order. You haven't set anything straight and in order. And so we become cowardice. We're afraid to deal with those things that are causing detriment unto the house of Israel. That's why the 5 years go to burn. Is there any man that, he said, can you find just one man that cry out against the injustice and the judgment and the wickedness among my people? We need that. Yes. You don't need to sit around and talk. You're talking, how to, if a man has such wisdom, he wants to sit around and talk. You ought to see the gift of that power in his life. You can't share a damn thing with me when I don't see it in your life. You can't tell me how to work when you don't know how to work. You can't tell me how to hit it when you ain't ready to hit it. You tell me that? No. Oh, hold up, man. Get away from me. I'll show you how to work, man. You can't tell me nothing when I don't see it in you. When I see it in you, you can tell. You can tell me. You can show me. Get out of my... Sit down, man. Preacher, you can... Just sit down. Stick on you. I love this preacher. I love him. I'm glad Yah has blessed him the way he has. I like him. I really do. Well, if I don't love him, how can I love you, my Eman? Tell me. Come on now. This is how I talk to me. I talk to me like this all the time. Because I know I'm wretched. If it was not for the gift that Yahshua bestowed upon me, there would be no gift. I was thinking this morning, I said, you know, as I was bathing my Eman, I said, you know, I was thinking again, I said, well, you know, I know I would have had what they call a career change. I went back to college, got my degree, and I probably would have been a professor at some school, some little small school, nothing large. My wife and I, that would have been my agenda, to become a professor and do all the scholarship work, writings, books, you know. And I know what my study would have been in, and I wanted to be the best at that. Hallelujah. So it is with you. I will give the devoted time, the will, the space, correction. There's not a man that stands up here and have taught. I don't care, even those that turn against me, that when they spoke something, it did not correct me. Everything corrects me. And we ought to always be corrected. The word correction is Musa, the counsel of Yah's wisdom. And the counsel of Yah's wisdom correct him. A mother sit down with her child, although she doesn't spank her backside, she said, then that's not the way to do it, baby. That's wrong. I came in the other day and, listen, Purr, I'll stop and pluck her ear. And they would say, well, she's acting moody. Look at her. So when she said, go on, man. So when I tried to kiss on her, she said, So mama, I said, it's not amazing, little baby girl. As though she doesn't wake up in the morning moody at times. I said, she wakes up moody. I know you're my Zakin, I love you. And I said that Ema, she dressed up, wake up moody. She said, well, not like that. Well, that's it. If you wake up one day in 20 moody, you're still moody. She may have wake up 5 days in one moody, so whatever does it make, you're still moody. We don't like for y'all to touch us. We don't like that. I want him to correct me. Correct me, Yahweh. You know, there's only one way he corrects us, in his judgment. And not in your, that's the difference between Af and Ibra. And not in your anger. Lest you bring me to low, to nothing. When Yah uses the word no or low, he means that there is not anything there when I finish. So he corrects us by judging our wickedness. I don't want him to bring me to nothing. I know it's a few of us, but I want to be around for a while. I want to help my young ark. I want men like him to be stronger. Stand with our Zachin, you men. We'll close in a minute. I want to get this through to us today. Listen, Yisroel, can I show us something? These fiery trials of this fire, this holocaust, this offering. I want to read this. There's something I want to read again that one of the most prominent, notorious historian concerning the word holocaust, it's definitive. Quote, when this word was first recorded in 1957, it was from the root or from the word of shu'ach or show, just like a show, which means the burnt offering, the whole of the burnt offering, Yisra'yah. That there is a cataclysmic, mayhem, catastrophic event that has taken place. It says this, quote, the word itself was used in English in reference to Hitler's Jewish policy from 1942, quote, but not as a proper name for those events. So the word Holocaust was not a fitting name that was proper for the events that took place. And when you see the word Holocaust capitalized, it pertains to one people, those that they call Jews. Contains to nothing else. Do you know how many people that were lost in what they call the Middle Passage or the dark hill skin color? No, this is history as well. Do you know how many was lost? The numbers between 50 to 80 million people were lost. That's not those that were brutally killed in this nation and in the Americas and around the world. That would be a holocaust, an offering of the burnt of the people. That's not those that were included on the land there, that they were brutally abused and killed. And we want to eradicate that out of our history. We don't want that to be told, to make our children dumb as hell and make us dumb as hell. We don't want that to be told. And so if anyone speaks like this, he's a racist. Go to hell. Yeah. Damn race. Yeah. You're the racist. Yeah. No other nation separated over the lines of demarcation of color of skin. It comes from this damn nation. Yeah. It comes from Mr. Binet. Yeah. You got that shysting still in you. That's why you have the moving twist when you hear that. Negroes always want to defend what is wrong. Well, he's going to hurt somebody. I don't care about hurting your feeling or his feeling or their feelings. Let's deal with truth. Get the mess out of us that we defend Torah. We don't defend no black man. We don't defend no damn white man. We don't defend no Jew man. We don't defend no Greek man. We defend Torah. We're set for the defense of Yah's Torah. I defend that. And I see how the white man has encroached upon that damn him. I will cut his head off. Any black man, these out there crying the same damn like Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. These are. I'm glad they don't like me. I'm glad. Oh, son, it's best to know who your enemies are. You feed them. Hallelujah. I want to give you a word of strength. There's a few things I want to read and then I want to move quickly. Bear with me. In the book of 1 Peter, the writing of 1 Peter, just one verse, two verses, chapter 4 and verse 12. Kepha addressed us, he said, beloved, those that are loved of Yah, he said, think it not strange, think it not strange concerning the Noah, the fiery trials. What are the trials meant for? I made reference to this word Noah in the beginning. Our trials are to make us shine. They're not to make us complain or become so agonizing in the midst of those trials. It's to show us our deficiency. And then in the midst of that, it calls the light, Yahshua is our oar. It calls the light of Yah's Torah, the light of Torah to shine. So he uses this word Noah, just like the word near means lamp or the light of Torah. So even don't think it's strange, Yisrael, for the fiery trials. The trials that enlightens your mind, that enlightens your confidence, that enlightens your trust in Yah. He says, think it not strange, the fiery trials, these masah, the great agony of battles, when you are in despair, when you have been tested. Don't think that that is strange, Yisrael. He said, which is to sarav, which is to try you. They are to refine you, to make you strong, to make you beautiful, as though that some strange thing happened to you. Oh, Yahweh, don't think it's strange when the bombs began to drop. I can tell you exactly where I was. The day of 9/11, 2002, I know exactly where I was. I can tell you exactly where I was when Mr. Bush began to drop those bombs on that nation. The anger raised in my heart. I was right there at Lowe's when 9/11 happened. And when they dropped those bombs on Mr. Hussein, I was on Highway 40. And I was listening to that Mahatma. I say, why these wicked people? These wicked people. They're so wicked. Iraq is a mess. Vietnam, 80% of their population is under 30 years old. They eviscerated. They destroyed people. Somebody's got to pay for that. We're in this nation, but you better not be of this nation. We're in the world, but not of the world. Come out of her, my people. You better come out of this nation because somebody's going to pay for that. Whatsoever man, be not deceived. Whatsoever man sow, that's all he reap. You kill all the babies, they're going to kill your babies. They're going to kill your babies. They're going to burn your babies. And the fools within this country is going to burn your own babies. I love my conservative government. Well, I'm a liberal and I love my liberal government. Mr. Barack Hussein Obama, he doesn't give a damn about burning a baby in a mother's arm there in any part of the world. He has the white mind just like that mind that is superior. It exalts itself. It esteems itself. It is greater than any mind. Just like Mr. Romney was saying yesterday that we help people to strengthen their constitution. You haven't helped those people in Iraq. You got the Sunnis and the Shiites killing each other every damn day. Look at this Arabic Spring. Well, hell, Egypt is a mess. It's a mess. You tore up Libya. Mr. Muammar Gaddafi caused the springs of the deserts to bring water into the cities. You've dismantled the whole thing. And you brought some democracy, a demon of greed and lust to kill each other. You haven't done a damn thing. You've divided a nation. You've destroyed a culture of people. And we don't want to speak against that. Something is wrong in your damn mind. That's what we should be speaking against. Don't call me and tell me no. I said, damn. When the man, I said, damn Farrakhan. Damn him. Undoubtedly, you disturb what I'm saying because things that you can go out here and say faggot, faggot, faggot all day long. Can I show an example? Give me a few moments. I worked at IBM and there was this cat. His name was Jeff Wotowicz. He was our technician. He would not share the information with me that was needed for me to make sure the processes will go smoothly. So he would not share that with me. So one day I said to him, I said, Jeff, I want to tell you something. I said it just like this. See, things that I know I'm not, it doesn't bother me. I said, you can walk through this place and you can cry, nigga, nigga, nigga. I don't like the word. I said, it wouldn't bother me one damn bit. When I said that, you know what he said to me? He broke down. He said, can I say this to you? I've always been very prejudiced. So I confess this. Well, I knew it was a prejudiced boy. I don't give a damn because you're prejudiced. Because you're weak, you're insecure, you're small. That's why you're that way. I said, I don't give a damn. I said, well, we got a corporation that there's a mandate we must be faithful to the cause. You give me the information, you don't have to worry about me. So things that people say that I know, I'm like, it doesn't offend me. They call me an occult. They say I got, I don't know how many wives some say I got. How many women I've lived. I know no woman but this woman. In nearly 40 years, I know no woman but this woman. 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 This is the only one. The only woman I know. I've touched no other woman. Never put myself in a position to go away from my responsibility to this woman. And if she did it to me, I would cut her head off. And I'll just rest in prison for the rest of my life. I don't have that many more years to live. So you can say things I'm not offended by because I know that's not me. You can talk about issues that I know that is a tender spot in this nation. But when you, anytime you begin to deal with the attitude of what we call racial profiling, people get scared. I'm not afraid to talk about it from here, from this place, because I know it's real and it exists. We got a constitution that said the middle of the diaspora was 1/3 of a man. Come on. It is still deep rooted in this wicked nation. You can't be afraid against it. We must speak out against it. We that are true Hebrews, you speak out against it. You dismantle the damn lies. Hallelujah. He says, don't think it's strange of the fiery trials that shall fire you. We're talking about a holocaust of death that shall come from Yah. He says in verse 13, 1 Kefa 4:13, but rejoice in as much as you are partakers. We are the partakers of Yeshua HaMashiach, his suffering. That when his tefireth, his great beauty of splendid, shall be revealed, when it shall be, I like that, revealed, his gala, when it is, the cover is pulled back. See, we allow the cover of our flesh to be eradicated and destroyed, then Yeshua will be revealed. When he shall be revealed, you may be glad with exceedingly joy. That's what the Shabbat is for. That we come to reveal the testimony of Yeshua's power. And we throw down us, we dismantle us. And when so, when we see that in each other, we rejoice. Look at my ak. We're glad to see them. Look at my hope. We're glad to embrace them and to kiss them. And that's why you're able to greet one another with a kadosh kiss. Yeah. Hallelujah. Yeah. So don't think it's strange. The fire that should try us, it is the fire of Yah. It is the fire. The nuclear bomb, that's no problem for us. Let them burn. The devil is going to burn his babies. He's going to try to kill all of them because he's trying to find every true Hebrew Yah Yisraelites. He is. But there's a prophet by the name of Ezra in 3rd Ezra. He gives us a confirmation here. Just listen to this. Don't worry about turning. You turn to Zechariah. Zechariah 13:9. Turn to Zechariah chapter 13 verse 9. But look what it says here in Ezra. Ezra says, then shall they be known. He's talking about Yisrael. Then shall the people of Yah be known. Yah says, who am I chosen? His ball here, his chosen. He's going to make known who are his chosen. He says this, and they shall be tried as gold in the fire. Is his words fire? Is his call, his voice, fire? We're going to be tried by the word of Yah, Yisrael. Then it shall be known who am my boy here. Isn't Yah ordaining this hour that shall be upon us? Sure he is. Well, I don't know that. Well, if you turn to Zechariah chapter 13, verse 9, I will show you. Zechariah chapter 13, verse 9. Yah says with an affirmation and a confirmation unto his nation. He says, and I will bring the third part through the ush, the fire. And Yah says, I am going to Saraf, I'm going to refine them. I'm going to refine them as silver is refined. I will try them. I will saraf them as gold is tried. He said, and then they shall call on my Hashem, my name. And Yah says, I will hear you in the midst of all of that. Even the beasts of the earth cried unto Yah. He heard them because he saw their book, their great affliction, their suffering, and their mourning. He said, and I will hear them, and I will say. This is what he will say. He said, it is my people, and they shall say, Almighty Yah, you my Abba. He's bringing us through. He's the one that is bringing us through, Yisrael. He's the one that is trying us and refining us. I need refining. And you cannot refine silver or gold with some little small fire. You need a fire. Let the heat burn, baby. You need a real fire. You can't smelt it to get the dross and those things that are detriment in that gold or silver. We need the fire. And his word is a consuming fire. He has said it. It's settled. That's enough, and I believe it. Then you shall know he is Abba and you're his people. When you have cooled, you have been sustained by the promises of Yah. You have gone through, you have maintained, you have contained the way of the power of his testimony. Isn't that so simple? It's wise, isn't it? Hallelujah. Let me close with this last aspect. This is for all of us. And this is one thing I want to speak today in the latter, just to remind us, to stir up our pure minds by way of remembrance. I want to remind us of one thing. And Yah's will, I'm going to conclude this next week because there's so much we need to teach. We need to teach. We need to be a people that's been taught. You can tell children that grasp things and those that do not. They don't look like the children who's there's a light of that knowledge shine forth in them, right? So it is with us. You can tell when a man grasps things, when he's searching to find something that he can think he can present. It doesn't mean anything. It doesn't mean anything. What we ought to do is search, allow Yah to search us. And he searches us by the fire and see if there be any wicked thing, any wickedness that handicap us, and that he may purge it out. He may clean. Search me. And so that's what he's doing today. He's searching me. He's showing you because when you get upset, when you got the mood, when you get ouch, oochie, ouch, you know you're wicked. I wish I had a man like this in my youth to teach me. I don't boast. I'm not worth a damn. I've done nothing more wrong than you. Your wrong is no different than my wrong. When Yah makes it right, would he separate you from your sin as far as the east is the west? How far is that? Hell, you can't even imagine from Cali to here how far that is. I know it's a long ride if you got to drive it. I've driven to Texas and all them places in Oklahoma, and that's a long, long ride. I left one morning, drove 1,100 miles going to Henrietta, Oklahoma. 1,100 miles. And they all sleeping. Can you imagine that? And as soon as I took a shower that evening, I didn't lay down for 1 minute and was asleep. As soon as I laid up, bam. I drove from here 1,150 miles. No, I drove 1,200 miles in one day. From here going to Louisiana, that the place up there, the beast that said, this is the messenger of Yah. I got something to eat when I laid down. It didn't take me 2 minutes to go out, or a minute. I went out like lightning. Boom. So that was a long way from home. And any time I started a journey back home, all I wanted was get home. I can't wait to see the Kedoshim. Well, you don't act like that because I want you to be refined, Yisrael. You all know me. I've never wanted to fraternize with your host or the men. When men began to talk so much, they began to lie. They began to promote them. I don't like that. When men have beauty and strength, they don't have to say much. I told you all the knowledge. I used to go to the gym, and this cat, his name was Warren. And I'm not lying to you. I've seen this woman. I see Warren. He didn't even want nobody to give him a spot until he was over 525 pounds. And this man's chest was like that, and he would get up there just boom. And everybody walked in the gym, well, they saw Warren because he was always standing there like this. He had on that type of uniform where here it was a one piece. His thighs were that big. He was a man. I'm not talking about a fat man. I'm talking about a man that was massive, no steroids. He was just a country boy. He was big. And everybody that would walk in the gym, boy, they see Warren, they go, because they knew that he was massive. He was devastating. And for some reason, when I would walk in the gym, I would look him right in their eyes. And I would walk. And he would go like this with me. And that's the way I respond to him. And come to find out, he was working. I didn't go to the dining hall of IBM much. He was working there. Come to find out, he was a man big as he was selling Avon. And after that, I couldn't get away from him. Listen. And steal. When I would go to the gym in those days, he was standing like that. We didn't talk. He would see me and he would go. And I would do the same thing. I see him at IBM. He's so loquacious. Oh man, you know, I got some nice smelling stuff. I'm like, I don't even go Avon way, man. Hallelujah. His strength was recognized. And everybody knew it. And when Warren got down to deadlift, or he didn't do but three disciplines. His arm was big as trunks. He deadlift, he squatted, and he benches. He didn't do no curls. He didn't do no triceps. And when Warren did that, everybody, they would see, hear them big clink, 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 and everybody stand back and look. The whole gym would get quiet because when Warren got down, everybody knew that he was the man. Warren was the man. You know why he was doing that? Because he wanted to be a wrestler. Yeah, I want to be a wrestler, man. Stop it. I want to close with this. Just hear this. It's out of the book of Baruch. The beautiful secretary of Yeremiah. He would hear what Yeremiah would speak out of the book of Baruch. First Baruch. Can I read this for you? I want to close with this to remind you who's in control. That used to be a song, Yah got it all in control. He got everything in control. The fire, it comes from Yah. He is the consuming fire. His word is the consuming fire. It says in the book of Baruch, hear this, in the book of Baruch, first Baruch, if you have that, first Baruch. I want to somewhat expedite this. First Baruch, chapter 4, verse 27. The first thing he tells us here, he says, be of tov comfort, or sa'at. Be of great comfort, Yisrael. Allow the Torah to support you. Allow it to sustain you. Allow Yah's truth to keep you established and firm in your desire, your passion for Yah. He says, be of excellent comfort, of tough courage. And Yah says, O my children, and cry unto Yah, Kara, for you shall be remembered of him that brought these things upon you. He says, Yah is going to remember you because he's the one that is bringing these things upon you. So he tells us to cry unto him. Za'ach. Cry for his help. We need to za'ach, say, Yah, I need you. You know, say, oh, I need Yah. Oh, Yah, I need you. Yah, please help me. Oh, please. Please, Yah. I can't do it. Oh, please. He says, za'ach. Cry for the special help of Yah. Because he is the one that brought you to these things. For as it was, he says, your leba, your mind. First Baruch 4:28. He says, for as it was your mind to go astray from Yah. Our minds go astray from Yah all the time, doesn't it? He said, your mind has gone astray from Yah. He says, so you know that, being returned, he said, I want you to seek him 10 times more. Are we seeking Yah greater today than we sought him yesterday? He said, what you need to do is seek him 10 times more. We can be all self-grandizing and say, I just love him, so I'm seeking him, so that's just a damn lie. We sell it. We were seeking for a dollar mart sale. We're seeking for something for our bellies, but we're not seeking him 10 times more. He said, your mind has gone astray, now returned. He said, shub, teshuva, make repentance. He said, once you realize that, seek him 10 times more. Seek him. Don't let anything circumvent your time for crying out to Yah. He says, seek him 10 times more. Hear this, Yisrael. First Baruch 4:29. For he that brought these plagues, for he that shall cause the holocaust, the fire, he that brought these plagues upon you shall bring you everlasting shimcha, everlasting joy. How? In his teshuah. Or with teshuah community. In his victory of deliverance. In his victory of salvation. In his victory of assurance. He says that with everlasting joy, with your deliverance. This is what Yah is going to express. It's an everlasting. It's the joy that is olam v'ad. He's going to bring out the teshuah. He's going to bring deliverance for his nation, Yisrael. He says, take a tov lev, O Yerushalayim, for he that gave you that name, he will comfort you. He gave Yerushalayim the name Yerushalayim, the city where the shalom of Yah is taught. It is where the city where the shalom of Yah is lomad. It is taught. It is the city of shalom. As long as we are in this shabbat, we turn toward Yerushalayim and pray. And Yah says, I know it's a silly jester. It sounds silly, but it's the truth. Yeah. He says, he shall shemach, he shall hear the cries of his nation Yisrael. He says, miserable are they that afflict you. Let them afflict you. They're miserable. They have their houses, their cars, their riches, their gold, and their silver. But they're miserable people. Yeah. They have no love. Yeah. He says, miserable are they that afflict you. And they rejoice at your nafal, your falling. Not just falling into sin, but you fall supplication unto Almighty Yah. He said, miserable are the cities which your children serve. The cities are in desolation. And your sons and your daughters are serving them on their jobs in their factory, sweeping their floors and all of that, abandoning their family. He said, miserable are the cities that your children serve. He said, miserable is she that receive your sons. What are you saying, Yah? Verse 33. For as she rejoiced at your ruins, as she rejoiced at your destruction, your desolation, your shomeh, as she rejoiced in your ruins, and was glad at your fall, at your failure, so shall she be grieved for her own desolation. Y'all say desolation is coming. The fire is going to burn from the heavens. The nuclear bombs mean nothing. Y'all says I'm going to bring some of you all through that. I'm going to show you that it is my Torah that refines you. That's why we must prepare ourselves daily, Yisrael. And you do that by examining your own laba. You examine your mind and see if you're in the imunah. When you get angry fast, you know you are a damn fool. That's what it says. This art brought it out. For folly ever, foolishness rusteth. It is the Shabbaton. It rusted in the shout, the bosom of a damn fool. The Torah tells us to be angry, but don't sin. Don't speak against Yisrael. Don't abandon Yisrael. You might as well love me. You might as well. I'm not going to tell you a lie. Dad and mama meant well. They didn't intend to tell you a lie, but they lied to us. Dad and mama deceived us. I was one they called here, and the one that spoke to this person asked them, do you agree with that man? Sure, she, the one agreed with Yeshua. And the response was, you only know what your mama taught you. You see the weakness of that individual? The person could not handle that conversation, so they slammed the telephone down. That's what we do. We shut our ears when Yah deals with us. We get angry and we close our ears to the truth. Just like to Zephaniah, Sophoniah, when he said, you are wicked, you're just like your daddy, you resist the power of the Ruach HaKodesh. See, when you shut your ears and they say, and they ran upon that and they gnashed that man with their teeth. That's the way you are. We shut our damn ears and think we're spiritual, trying to find something. You need to find the wickedness of your heart and say, Yah, help me. Hallelujah. I can't teach those sugar-coated teachings. Hallelujah. I'm a simple messenger of Yah. That's what I am. I'm not a great messenger. I'm a simple one. I don't want to be great. No, I don't want to be great. And the expression of my greatness anyway be to serve you, to make sure that your grass is mowed if I have to mow it. Make sure that the dining hall is warm if I have to cut wood. Make sure the houses are properly taken care of. That's the great man. Not because he talks. If you want to be great among Israel, you serve the people. That's how you're doing. This is cheap here. That's why T.D. Jakes can get up here with a $3,000 suit on and $1,500 alligator shoes. You got a whole favor. Come on. Cause the forensic and the women get crazy. Yet that mother is working every day to try to supply bread for a house, and you rob her every damn dime. It's easy for you to say that. You don't even touch them. You don't even shake their hands. You don't even integrate. There are folks, I heard a man say, I have been here at Potter's House for 10 years. I've never had the opportunity to shake T.D. Jakes' hand. Never. We see each other every day. Let me close out here. He says this, listen. For I will take away the rejoicing of the great multitude and her prides. Yes, pride. Gaun. The pride. I'm going to take away their pride. Shall be turned into mourning. Look what Yah says here now. First Baruch 4:35. For the fire. This is our comfort here. For the fire shall come upon her from the everlasting Abba Yah. That's where the fire is coming. This exalted Bavel mind that says that it's going to cause fire to burn. Yah is going to cause the hell of heavens to burn. Yah says, I'm going to send fire. He says, long to endure. And he says this, listen, and she shall be inhabited. She shall be inhabited of devils for a great time by Shadim, by demons and powers. And there are those that are in the fellowship of Yisrael, they're inhabited by demons. It has been in them for a long time. They're the same way they were 30 years ago, 20 years ago, they're the same way. We act the same way we did 10 years ago, 10 days ago. Y'all say they shall be inhabited by demons for a long time, for a great time. That's why the spirit of Yerushalayim today is Sodom and Egypt. That's the spirit on that nation. And that's the spirit on our mind because Yerushalayim represents the city of Shalom. We are not a city that sits upon a hill. So we represent the very nature and the nurturing of Yerushalayim. That it is the Shalom of Yah that speaks to us. When he corrects us, when he rebukes us, when he judges us, it brings Shalom to us. Not a damn disgruntled stupidity of our minds and our conscience and an attitude that is funky and wicked. Yah says, Yerushalayim, look about you toward the east. That's a powerful teaching, what comes from the east. I'll teach that one day. And behold the joy that comes unto you from Yah. All these trials. For we know that joy comes from Yah. Weeping may endure for a night. But the Shimcha of Yah comes. In the Lahin. In the Bucha. In the Bucha. In the morning. He says this, lo, your sons come, whom you sent away. They come, gather together from the east to the west. How? By the word of the Kadosh One. Rejoice in the splendor of Yah. That's what you do. Yah is going to bring his nation together. He's going to bring us together. He's going to cause us to be revived. How do we survive? How do we cool? How do we sustain? There's only one way, Yisrael. We got to get this truth in us. And we can't be hypocrites. We cannot be a sonif. That's what a hypocrite is. A sonif. Sonif. We can't be hypocrites. We got to be genuine and sincere. If I'm not sincere, you all don't listen to me. Turn it off. You all run from me. Find you some other way. Because you can't help me because you are wicked and you're trying to slither in like a snake or a dog, and I won't allow it. I'm going to cut your damn rush off. Because of your arrogance and your pride, I'm going to cut your head off. And I'm not going to feel sorry when I cut it off. And cut off your little juvenile ascending up in the heights of your own frivolous knowledge you think you possess. I will cut your head off. I don't take that back. That's what a warrior does. Uriah died for David. Isn't that amazing that we trust no man, but yet he trusted his king? And he was willing to die. He had a beautiful wife. He had a beautiful wife. And David tried to seduce him because David knew he had done wrong by him. I've done wrong by no man. Done wrong by no other man's daughter, his wife. I've done wrong by no man. Hallelujah. I've done wrong by no man. Hallelujah. I've done wrong by no man. I haven't seduced their daughters or raped their children. I haven't robbed them of nothing. I've done wrong by no man. Yeah. I've done wrong by no man. Yeah. I have not done that. Yeah. And although David tried to seduce him, he said, my love for my king is greater. But I got Ark out there in the field battling, and we are such a damn selfish. That's what this wicked whore has taught us, to be selfish, unappreciative, and we don't love no damn body. We don't consider those that are in great agony and pain, and there are more Yisraelites than you are that love Yah. You don't even consider them because you're a damn self-predicated individual that base things upon your own concept of what beauty is and what your worth is, and you never pray for them. When a shown of Zacchaeus and men of strength, they will come into Yah's house and say, let's pray. You will find out who's strong then. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that's the truth, Yisrael. Whether you buy it, I really don't care. Whether you love me, I will not lose one ounce of sleep. Whether you stand with me, Yoshua went to the stake. They all forsook him. So Yah says one thing. I know when men and those have forsaken the labor of Yah here. It's one thing, as Azachim brought out. It is the transgressions of the lips. Because iniquity or von or vin. What is transgression, the define of Torah? Because transgression shall abound and shall manifest itself with the great fester in the hearts of many. It says the love of many shall wax cold. So when you find a cold devil, you know they're full of iniquity. I don't care if it's your mammy, your pappy, or you. I don't give a damn. How about that for a statement? You're finna y'all every day with your cold nature. You can tell a very gentle person their kindness, their beauty. You can tell from here. That's why I tell us all the time, we need to watch this. I'm going to teach you on that again. You can tell when someone is gentle and kind and beautiful. Damn hard forehead. You can tell that. Well, you say you don't speak to people. Well, David on last week, the last time that he looked at me, he smiled. He said, this week he didn't even look at me. As a matter of fact, he asked me, you with her? Stop it, man. You know I'm with this woman. I don't know what he was mad about. I didn't make him mad. It's his own sin. And that is what destroys you. It is your own chatah, your own sin, your own wickedness, that you have esteem above the truth of Yah, and you think to yourself to be someone strong and mighty. When you find a strong man, everyone will gravitate to him. You find a beautiful woman, people ask them questions. How are you so beautiful? What have you done? You find a wise man, people will ask them. I watch the many that have come here. Many have left. And many thought that they were wise.
Now they gravitated to them. They don't gravitate to me. Well, are you sad? No, I'm not sad because of that. I like to study. I mean, I like to study. Hallelujah. I like to lay down in the Torah. I like to study. And I see that one little word, I say, ah, boy. I preached that, but he didn't see that one. Oh, my. I said to the Ak, I don't know how many messages I can preach on that. I can preach on that. Now, I don't look at, I'm not looking for things to get what he preached. You're trying to show how refined I am. I got so many messages out of what he preached. I said, oh, wow, if he went down to the next verse, I can preach that. Nobody know I got that for him. He didn't patent that. I said, I can preach that what he was talking about. I see that. I can preach on that. Whoa! Can't go around. We're going to close. Can I close? I can't. Of young, oh, you cannot stand up. Hold up. We greet you all. May the riches of Yah rest upon you all, our friends, sin and offering. You're stingy and you're tight. We don't need it. We're going to be all right. But say the gift. You've eaten from the table of Yah today. It's right to do it. Hallelujah. We greet you all in Yahshua's name. Oh, you cannot go around. Torah of Yah. Come on, Al. Can go around. Oh, the Torah of Yah. Oh, yes, so high. Oh, you can't get over here. So high. You cannot go around. Oh, yes, so low. Reaches down to our sin. Can't go around all the Torah of Yah. I'm so glad you cannot go around the Torah of Yah. Oh, you must come in at the door one more time. Oh, you cannot go around the Torah of Yah. Cannot go around all the Torah of Yah. Oh, you can go around, oh, the Torah of Yah. Oh, you must come in at Yahshua. Hallelujah. Again, Yah Barak you all. May the riches of Yah and Yahshua rest upon you all. I haven't garnered too many friends over the years, have I? May too many love me. Not too many care for me. They all say they love me. I'm not sad. I don't lose 1 ounce of sleep. I'm not broken because of that. I'm happy. I am happy and the children love me. In Yeshua. See, my boy, I'm the back that he, when I get them, look at how that's up. No, don't. You know how they are. They're just too silly. And where I'm going to go? And Hadassah, she's down there going. So I stop in the house with her and Ahava. I say, you all go this way. Just give me that beat. That's all right. You all can stay deadheads. I said, I'll let us stand to our feet. Yah Barak you all, Yisrael. Hallelujah. I hope the word cut you up and restored you in every way. In all things, our precious Abba, we do Barak you in your Yahshua's mighty name. For this great day that is blustering and so beautiful, yes. This Shabbaton, yes. This Shafat, the rest, and then your Ruach of Shaftim, spirit of your judges among your people, bless us all. Those that join us for the live broadcast, we tell that you for them all, our enemies, our friends, we bless you for all. We hope that they have been fed. We pray for every house that have joined us. We pray for your nation scattered abroad. We pray for those that are true Yisrael.
Move out every unclean thing among your nation, your people. Restore us in Yeshua. And bless us all that we may rejoice this Shabbat. And as we come back at the close of this Shabbat to pray and rejoice and have a greater hava for each other. We ask all things in Yeshua's mighty name. Bless our ima, our zachin, our elder, our young, our babies as well. Look upon them or heal the bodies of those that have pain. Our zachin, bermin, our ach Yosef, I need them, Yah. Bless ach Yosef, the little pain that it may subside in me. You may heal him completely in Yeshua's mighty name. We pray for all Yisrael, our precious ones scattered abroad to nations, those that are living under such tyranny of poverty and great agony. Bless that hope that has 6, 7 children with no man. Her husband has been lost to the cruelty of this world, and she has no one to embrace her. Bless her. Her heart cries out continuously. Strengthen her. And may that she may hear the word from the wayfaring of the stranger in her midst, that Yah is the reward of Yisrael. Bless all, I pray in Yeshua's name. Give us all rest this evening. Take Yisrael home safe. Those that have traveled and watch over them, bless us all. And above all, we pray that you berach in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach, that all the earth at that name, that the heavens and the earth bow and everyone fall prostrate. We ask it all in that most dynamic, magnificent, magnanimous name. In Yeshua's name we do berach you, Yah. And with the depths of our bosom we cry, hallelujah. 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 Yah, berach Yisrael. Woo, I'm tired.